everyone and welcome to my channel and to this video which is an introduction to the digital drawing app Procreate. In this video, I will teach you the very basics of Procreate which you will need to know if you want to start becoming a Procreate artist. After watching this video, make sure to check out my other videos which will have other tutorials related to Procreate along with time lapses of artworks which I have done. Now, let's get started. I am going to assume that you have by now already downloaded the app Procreate from the App Store. So, I'm just going to go ahead and open this app. So, it is this particular app which has the rainbow colored brush mark as its logo. So, I'm just going to click that and I come up into a gallery screen. As you can see, in my gallery, I have all the artworks which I have already done. And as you can see, I have done many scribbling artworks as well, which you can ignore. But when you come into Procreate, you are most probably going to see just these top four paintings, which are example paintings, which are provided by Procreate. So now I'm going to show you how exactly do you start a painting. It's pretty simple because all you have to do is click this little plus on the top right corner and you will get these options. By default, I'm assuming that you have the option screen size, square, A4 and a few others. I normally like to take canvases of the size square or A4 or masterpiece. However, I do like to create some custom sizes as well, and you can create any canvas of any size that you want. So I'm just going to go for screen size right now to show you how it looks. So you come up onto a blank screen like this. Now how do you adjust the size of the canvas is you just hold two fingers onto the screen and pinch to make it small and push your fingers apart to enlarge the screen. Now how this will be useful is like this. Let me show you with the help of another example. Let's just take one of the Procreate examples. So as you can see, this is already done. So I'm going to just make it a bit smaller. And now I'm going to show you what exactly you can do by enlarging the picture. So when you enlarge it, you can go deep into the details to the size of just pixels and you can make any change that you want. Now this is pretty useful while making very intricate designs and some many tiny features of a drawing. But otherwise, a regular size will suffice. However, many times you will have to resize your screen and you can do it as per your convenience. Now, since we're already in the screen, let me just take you through the basic features. So on the left-hand side, by default, you will have this option to enlarge and reduce the brush size. The bottom one is to see the brush opacity. And then you have the undo and the redo button over here. Now a shortcut for the redo button is tapping on the screen with two fingers and a shortcut for the redo button is to tap on the screen with three fingers and the shortcut for the undo button is to tap on the screen with two fingers. Excuse me for that small mistake. This little square in the middle is a color picker. So when you click it, you get this circular thing here, which you can run over any part of the drawing and it will pick the color which is on top of that little plus symbol there. So, and a shortcut for this is to just hold on the screen with any finger for a few seconds. So as you can see, the plus mark is on this blue color and that is why the color which is going to be selected is blue. In this method, you can copy any colors. For example, if you are copying an artwork, then all you need to do is you can paste the artwork here, then you can copy paste the exact colors, or if you're looking for any photograph which you're trying to copy, you can just find the exact colors by using this method. And you will have no discrepancies. Now let me show you the brushes. For that, let me take this fresh screen. Actually, let me just show you how a square looks, just as an example. Okay, so it's something like this, which is a square. So now I'm going to just go to the color palette right here. So it will open onto this disk screen. So here you can change the base colors and then the shade and the tone of the colors. Here you can change the hues, and here you change the tone and the shade. Now let me just show you a few more features in the color palette. Now down here you can see that there is an untitled palette. Now how do you change the palette is pretty simple. You go all the way to this palette option on the rightmost corner, and you will find various pre-prepared palettes. I think these are the ones which are pre-prepared. However, you can create any number of palettes that you want, and you can create one palette per artwork which you do. You can also download palettes from YouTube videos, and you will also be able to download palettes from my YouTube videos very soon. So you create a new palette by just clicking the plus, then going to create new palette, and then you can set it as default unless you want to set any other one as default. If I set this as a default, then in the disk, this is the palette which is going to pop up. Now, another thing that you need to know for the palettes is how to create colors into it. It's very easy. All you have to do is choose a color, let's say this blue color. And all I need to do is, once I select it, just tap in the palette anywhere in the screen once, and the color will appear. Any color you can use to do that. Now here is another method, that's the classic method. And these are all various types to do your colors. Now all this I will go more in detail in another video. However, this is one thing important to mention, that if you want to use a hexadecimal code, all you have to do is enter it here under the value section right here. Okay, I think that's enough about the colors for the moment. Now let me show you these two tiny little squares here. So these are the layers. Now layers are very important, and it really makes drawing pretty simple on the iPad. So all you have to do to add a layer is to click the plus sign, and you can go on adding layers. You can move a layer by just tapping and holding on it and then moving it to the designated spot. Then you can also select the background color to anything that you want. And here, if you click the little N over there, you can change the opacity of the layer from none. Let me just show you one second. So let's just say I just scribble something here. Okay, now I'm going to just go to lower the opacity. So as you can see, it just goes on decreasing, increasing, decreasing and increasing. Now here there are various options which helps in changing the color of whatever drawing you have done based on the color below it. Now you may find this a bit difficult to understand, so I'm not going to go into this in this particular video, but let me just tell you that it is a very interesting feature, and you can experiment around with it and you'll be pretty impressed on how well it works. Next is the eraser tool. Now, I think before this, I should show you the brush section. So you just click on this little paintbrush and you come up on the brush section. Now, naturally, by default, you will have all these brushes already available in your iPad. So you can just scroll up and down. There are a huge variety of brushes that you can choose from with different textures like this. Oh, I don't know why it's not working. Oh, it's pretty dull because, as you can see, the brush opacity got decreased to 1% by some reason. I'm going to just make it maximum brush layer, and you can see I can create all these beautiful designs. Then crystals, you can create just crystals like this. And my favorite is the luminescence. You can do this. Now here, this glow line brush is one that me and my sister have created by ourselves. So all these you can experiment around with it and you will really enjoy yourself. Now another thing that is there is that you can create a brush on your own by clicking this plus sign over here. Now there are so many things about each brush. Like when you go here and you click on this, then you can change so many properties of this brush. Now I think that this deserves another detailed video all about brushes, so I'm not going to get into it, but let me tell you, you don't really need to know all these things about brushes, because you can make most of the drawings without having to create a brush. Now the most widely used brush is a technical pen, then a script pen for any writing work, and I like to use a Narinder pencil for any of my sketching. I normally like to sketch in a navy blue color, something over here, and I like to sketch with full opacity and full size. Now coming to eraser, when you have drawn in one particular size of brush or a type of brush, you may want to erase also using that same brush. And that's why here, let's say I've drawn with a Narinder pencil, then I can go to sketching, choose Narinder pencil, and I can erase as well with this brush, and it erases to the base color. As you can see, it is erasing. Let me show you with a bigger brush what I mean. For eraser, normally I like to go for a round brush or a flat brush. And as you can see, because the size was so enormous of that brush, it erased the entire screen in one stroke. But otherwise, you can go like this. Or if you just want to decrease the shade of a particular one, you just need to rub over it like this by decreasing the opacity here. You can experiment with all this and you will have a lot of fun. Now this smudging tool here also has the same variety of brushes. Now this is to smudge like this. So suppose I want to create like a watercolor effect or like you're painting on a real canvas. That's why I use the smudging tool, which blends in together all the brushes. I find this to be a really helpful tool while I'm making my drawings. So you can just smudge it in and make it like an actual painting. So now I'll just show you this little arrow. So the arrow is to select whatever is on that particular layer. So as you can see, on this layer we have all these things. So I'm going to select the entire layer. I can decrease the size, increase it, turn it around, move it here, there, anywhere. So this comes into a lot of use if we want to draw something tiny, because we can draw it big on a separate layer, then we can select that layer and decrease the size. Now this one here is a selection tool. Now this is a bit more complicated and is not that vastly used, so I'm not going to go into that today. Now this is the magic brush set. So in this, the Gaussian blur is my favorite, because it works pretty much the same way as a smudge tool, where you can blur out and help blend in all the colors. I also use motion blur a lot, just like this, to help spread out the colors. Now here is the settings. Here, by clicking on the video and the time lapse replay, you can find the time lapse. Then you can choose some settings here, but normally you would like to on your drawing guides, and you can edit the drawing guide to symmetry, rotational symmetry, radial, or anything like this one. It draws on all the sides, and you can create really nice pyrography, mandalas, etc. So this is the basis of Procreate. And one last thing that I forgot to mention is these features here, that is the select. So all I need to do is select a few artworks just like this, and I can just say stack, and it will all become like a folder. I can click on that and rename this stack. So I want to delete this stack, because I already have all these photos with me. So I'm just going to swipe to the left and I'll get these three options, and I'm going to press on delete I'm going to delete them. So that was it about the basics of Procreate. Now there is a lot more to it, of which half of it even I don't know how to use it properly. But this should be enough to get you started to doing some simple but beautiful artworks. Now make sure to be subscribed and to hit the notification bell so that you are notified whenever I post my next video on Procreate, which may also contain a tutorial to some gorgeous paintings which you can easily do even if you're just a beginner. So with that, thank you all. Have a nice day. I'll see you in my next video. Namaste.